बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू द सेकंड पार्ट फॉर द लेक्चर नंबर 9। इन द लास्ट पार्ट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द इनिशियलाइजेशन और जेनेरिक इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट एक्सेसलेस कंट्रोल ACL। सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द स्टैंडर्ड एक्सेस लिस्ट विद डिटेल। आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट द मेन थिंग अबाउट दिस स्टैंडर्ड एक्सेस लिस्ट इज दैट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम 1-2 एंड इट गोज फ्रॉम टूवर्ड्स 99, so you can have this much of entries, and you can also have this entry as well from 1600 to 1999, 1999, and you can either block a network or a host or a subnet, and this is a two-way communication. We have already discussed that all the services are blocked. This is implemented closest to the destination. And filtering is done based upon only the IP source IP address. So this is the main feature of the methodology of creation of a standard access list. How can you create a standard access list? So for that you have to configure, and then you have to mention the access list, that which access list you want to configure. And then you have to provide the sequential number, and then you have to provide the entry, that if you want to allow that or that is permit, and if you want to deny that entry. So this is the kind of configuration for which you are going to use, which you will have to use actually for the creation of that ACL. So now this is example to implementation of a standard ACL. Configure interface, interface type and interface number, and there is also another method, that is configuration of if you are using the IP address, you have to you have to allow the access group. So you have, in this kind of scenario, you have to basically permitting or denying a complete set of group to a host or to a server or to any other network to through your router. So you can also manage the groups over here, you can also manage our interfaces over here, you can also manage some specific entries over here. So there are certain, these are certain methodologies that from which you can control create this ACL. And to verify, you have to just write down the command, that is show access list and show access list specific number. So if you want to check the access list on a specific number, you can use this command as well. This is for specific number command, that if you want to check that what is the type of connectivity, either it is permit or it is denied for a specific entry, let's say for 36 or 37, let's say. So for entry number 37, you can use this command show access list, and the number should be 37. Instead of this number, you can put 37, and it will give you the status of that specific entry. The second type was extended access list, and you know that the extended was from 100 to 199, and it has a advanced version. Instead of just network, host and subnet, it also provides you to manage the service type actually, and it is only providing you one-way communication. And that will be stopped, and mostly I've already told you UL is blocked, and it is mostly implemented towards closest to the transmitter, implemented close to the source. And selected services can also be blocked, and it basically checks the source, destination, protocol and even the port number as well. So you can manage these all these in the EACL, that is extended access control list. And this is a type of access extended control list items. You can see that IP, UDP, TCP, we have already discussed these much, but now we are going to connect these. So this is the type, these is examples that you can have under this extended control list. You can let's say, for example, I have already given you the example of ARP. So you know that ARP provides you a list of entries that are there. Similarly, if you want to see the IPs, so you can have the IPs, list of IPs. Similarly, if you want to trace a route, you have the list of the entries that your packet was gone from here to, so you know that this was a sequential order and it is a kind of list, and it is basically the access control list. So these are some correlations between the previous list that we have discussed in the previous lectures of midterm, and in the final term now we are heading towards our next target and next topics that are remained in the lecture. So there are certain operators that are involved while you are checking or operating with ACL. So the first one is EQ, that is equal to, that is not, this one is not equal to, or you can say the negation. This is a sign for negation, not equal to. This is not equal to. And IT is less, this is LT, this is less than, and GT is for greater than. So you know that you can have these four options basically, either they are equal or they are not equal, and if they are not equal, it should be either the less or greater than each other. So this is the example of creation of extended access list, how you can create extended access list. So for that you have to, the first method is that you have to provide the access list, which access list you want to create or configure. Then you have the entry, and then you have to allow the status of connectivity that you either want to allow or deny, that is permit or deny. Then you have to enter the protocol, that which protocol you want to. Then you have to enter the source address. Then you have to enter the source WCM. Then you have the destination address. Destination WCM, basically this is a machine generator code, and the last you will have to put the operator and as well as the service. The second method of implementation of this is the implementation of the extended accesses is that you have to provide the interface type, interface number. So I've told you that in this kind of ACL list, that is extended ACL, extended access control list, you have to basically provide the interfaces information as well. So that is why it has some difference between, there is some difference between extended and standard version of ACL. And similarly in the extended access list, as you see that this also provides you to manage a group as well. If you want to provide a group as a whole connectivity or denial service, you can provide that as well using this command as well. And you can either block or out or inbound or outbound traffic as well for a specific group. So this is a kind of implementation data that you can use with while you are configuring your ACL access control list. Now the main theories about the named access list, that it in the named access list, the access list are identified using the names rather than the numbers, and names are case sensitive. For example, if you are using this Google, so this Google will be different. You know that this is case sensitive, so this Google will be different from, let's say, this Google. So let's say this is another Google. So this entry will be different from this entry because these names are case sensitive. You know that this is all the, these are all capitals and the last one is lowercase. Similarly, these are the all lowercase except this one is the uppercase. So this is basically case sensitive. There is no limitation of numbers here. You can have any as much entries as you want, but you know that if you are using named access list, you can have two versions. One is standard, the second one is extended. So there is no limitation of the numbers. If you are using from 1 to 99, you can be in this list, and if you are using greater than 99 and less than 200, you can use this extended list. So there is no limitation for the numbers over here. You can have both of these options. And one main advantage of this editing is editing in this of ACL is possible over here, and you can remove a specific statement from the ACL using this rather than the sequential order, you can remove a specific statement from the ACL. So this is provided to you by the name. You can manage using the name because this is not combined with the number services, and this is not the option for you in the numbered access list or category. iOS version 11.2 or later allows named ACL. The version greater than this 11.2 or later will be allowing you to edit this named ACL. And this is the standard, this is the repetitive slide for that standard name access list, and this is the extended name list for the as well. So let's talk about the concept of firewall in the ACL or access control list. We know that this ACL is acting as a firewall. So what is the what is the concept behind that? So you can use SDM or security device manager to create the access control list, and you can use using this SDM administrator can accomplish all the tasks that formally required the use of CLI, that is control link interfaces or control list interface. So you can use this SDM, and this SDM basically is a tool that is used by Cisco to provide you to allow, and this tool allow you to create a standard or an extended access list very much easily. That is why it is known as ACL, and this software or this tool is basically known as SDM or Security Device Manager, and it is provided to you by Cisco. And using this SDM to create a router firewall, unlike the control list interface, the SDM allows a router to be configured as a firewall as well. Now what does this mean? You can show, you can see with this diagram as well. This is the interface of Cisco router, and this is taken from your book that is provided to you for this course. So this Cisco router, this is Cisco router SDM. You can see the caption over here, Cisco router, and this SDM, that is Security Device Manager. And from here you can firewall and access control list. You can create a firewall, you can edit a firewall policy, and you can put a ACL, and you can also provide some application security over here as well. So there are two options for you. For the first one is basic firewall, and the second one is advanced firewall. And there are also this basic security feature options, further options. The first one is providing you the high security, the second one is providing you the medium security, and the last one is providing you the low security. And you can also preview the commands and how you can implement this security as well using the commands. A high security means the router basically identifies the inbound and outbound instant messaging and peer-to-peer traffic and drops it. So this is the description for the high security, this is the description for the medium security, and this is the description for the low security. You can see that low security does not provide you much services as compared to the high security and medium security, both of these. Let's talk about the edit firewall policy. You can see that you can manage originating traffic, that voice traffic that you are originating, that you want to control that originating traffic, and you can also control the returning traffic that is returning towards the router. So you can use both of these. So if you click on this originating traffic, it will provide you the list of the items and the device sources, IPs, address and destinations, and their services and their actions, that if they are allow and permit or deny. You can change this as well from here using this Cisco routers, and you can see that you can apply changes and discard. If you have made some changes, you can apply changes, or you, if you want to edit somewhere else, you can discard changes as well. So this is basically a Cisco router feature that is provided to you by the tool SDM. So let's re-summarize our lecture for this today's topic. In today's class, we discussed about the access list, that what are access lists. So you know that I've told you that access lists are one of the most important iOS tool for controlling a network traffic and implementing security features inside a network using a router. Access lists are created in two-step process. This is a two-step process. All the access lists are created sequentially and applied sequentially to all the packets that interface when the list is applied. So you have to allocate or specify the destination or the sequence of the packet, or you have to allow the service, or you can basically define the host, or you can block some block or permit a specific network. And you can also take this further towards the extended ACL by providing the interfaces information to that as well. By default, access lists always end in an implicit deny any statement. So I have already told you that implicit deny is basically the default deny statement, and it denies all the traffic within a router. Only one access list per direction, inbound or outbound, per protocol can be applied to an interface. You can see that one interface can have only one access list per direction. So if an interface has, you can see that if an interface has, this is the router, this is the interface, and it is outbound and inbound as well. So you will have minimum of you will require minimum of two access list per. You can see that there are two directions, so there will be at least two access list for the inbound and outbound per protocol. Likewise, standard IP access list allow you to filter a traffic based on the source IP address of the packet. So you can use this permit and deny statements for a specific IP address by a source. You can the best example for this is the MAC filtering that you mostly use in your hostels or your homes. Extended IP address provides you filtering based upon source, destination, protocol type, and the application type. So this is the most common access list that is maintained or managed by the university campuses, because they want to block or deny specific protocol or specific application. So for there, they use specific or extended IP access list. Access list can be used to restrict telnet by controlling YT line access. So these are different applications. We will be learning about these terms in the coming lectures, inshallah. But this access list you can use to restrict a network connection to another network. There are two different networks. Let's say this is for telnet and this is for VTY. So if you want to block all the traffic from this side to this side, you can actually put some filtering on this side using this router ACL. And ranges from numbers represent all the access list. And in the last, we discussed about the SDM, that is Security Device Manager, to configure both the standard and extended ACLs via the additional task configuration lab that is provided to you by Cisco router configurations. The STM can be used to configure a router as either a basic or advanced level firewall. For basic, you can have a high level, low level, and medium level. And in advanced firewall, you can have multiple options based upon your own customization, based upon your own requirements, and based upon the client's requirements. So if a client wants you to customize their own firewall, you can use advanced firewall system instead of the basic firewall system, because basic provides you three layers, that is three options, that is high security, medium security, and the low security. The main difference between a basic and advanced firewall is the ability to configure the DMZ interfaces in the advanced firewall setup. I've already discussed this in the examples as well. So that is all for today's class. I hope that you have learned much things in today's lecture. This is the second part, and if you have any questions, you are welcome to ask. You can put your questions or confusions on my email on the portal as well. I'll see you in the class. That's all for today. Allah Hafiz.